this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you. What I'm doing today in the garden is simply just taking my pre-made potting soil mix and putting them in my Grow'em self-watering containers. I used the Grow'ems last year when I got them actually for the fall slash winter garden, and they worked great. They're self-watering, they held water really well, and everything grew amazingly in it. Then the spring came and it still did all right, but then the summer came, it got wicked hot and these guys were just drying out way too quickly. So actually, I think I have maybe only three left that are still growing what I grew last year, which is pretty cool because, you know, those guys are just still growing. I'm harvesting food off that. I got the beets, the onions, the onion chives, and some mints and other herbs in one of the bins. So great success. I'm using them again. Definitely recommend them. But you know, while I'm gardening, I'm often listening to music, but I'm also thinking a lot. And one of the things that I was thinking about today and that I wanted to share with you guys, my thought for today, was why do you garden? You know, I want to know why you guys garden. I mean, I know why I garden, and this kind of comes back to a comment. I mean, I read a lot of the comments that I get. I can't read each and every comment I ever get on all my videos because that'd be a full-time job just reading comments. But I usually do scan over, you know, the current video that I just uploaded and scan over the comments for the first couple days to kind of read them, but I, you know, don't have the time to answer each and every one, which I apologize. But the comment said something like, I can't do your gardening method, man, because you got to buy too much stuff for your gardening method. And it's totally true that, you know, the way that I teach you guys how to garden, you may not need, may have to buy some stuff if you want the best results. You know, there are ways to do it for free or cheap, and I'll mention that at the end of this video. But, you know, and you know why I use this method is because it's based on why I'm gardening. And, you know, my videos are sharing my ideas about gardening and, you know, also which will share my ideals or goals about gardening. And you know, it all is reflected on the reason why I'm gardening. And so, you know, I want you, before I even say my reason, to go down below the video and post a comment real quick and, you know, tell me why you're gardening, whether it's one word, to save money, or whether it's to avoid GMO foods, or whether it's to eat healthier, whether it's to have something to do in your spare time because you're retired and it keeps you out of trouble like it keeps me out of trouble. Whether you, because you're a sun worshiper and you love being in the sun with your shirt off or maybe even gardening naked sometimes to get some vitamin D and to hopefully, you know, not have your neighbors look at you when you're gardening naked. They might get scared. But I don't, there's so many different reasons to garden. I mean, maybe you just like getting back to nature and getting your hands in nature. Maybe you like to see the process of plants, you know, grow and that you actually did something with your two hands. Whatever it is, post it down below so that I get an idea about it. It'll help me in future videos kind of tailor my videos, you know, for the various reasons that are given. I mean, maybe you're gardening because it's the most sustainable way to live. If you grow your own food, maybe you're gardening because you're taking responsibility for yourself and you want to take responsibility instead of push responsibility on something else. You know, when something doesn't go right, you know, you gotta own up to it, man. I mean, this is something we learn hopefully as adults, because I still have friends that, you know, hey, did you do this? No, I didn't do it. No, I mean, and I know they did it, even though they say they didn't do it, right? So just own up to it and apologize and make it right. But take responsibility, you know, don't put the responsibility of your health on your doctor or, you know, the food you're eating on a chef that's making all your food. You know, take responsibility for yourself. Don't let the stores dictate to you what you're gonna eat, because if you shop at the store, you're gonna eat what they produced or what the farmers and the companies produced. You know, maybe you wanna take control because you like being in control. I like being in control. I like being in control of what I'm eating, man. I don't wanna have to eat the stuff at the store when they say, oh, you gotta eat these tomatoes picked at this time, especially when it's the winter time and they all pretty much suck because they're picked too early and they're still pink and they're not red and they don't taste good. I mean, maybe you're gardening because you just love the flavor, man, and you grew up in Italy and you just knew what a tomato tasted like, and the crap at the stores they sell now is just bogus and it doesn't taste good. So it pissed you off so much you just started gardening so you could have good tasting stuff. Maybe you're a chef. Maybe you're a chef and you just know that the stuff that they send you off the truck every week and you make food, it just doesn't taste good, doesn't have any flavor. You know, so you started growing a garden to serve better food to your clientele. I mean, there's so many different reasons why people garden and grow food. Maybe you're a survivalist, right? You're like, man, if shit hit the fan, I don't want to be stuck and have no food. That's why I'm learning how to garden now, just in case shit hits the fan. I'm going to be really good at it. So if shit does hit the fan, I'm going to know how to make food for me and my family, and I'll be, you know, taken care of. You know, instead of just like raiding stores and all this kind of stuff, you'll have your own food source. I mean, literally, all we need is a few things: shelter, water, and food. I don't know, maybe we don't even need shelter. You could live out in below a bridge crossing. So as you guys heard, there's so many different reasons to grow food. And now before I share you my top reason, because, you know, a lot of the reasons I stated are my reasons, absolutely. But of all the reasons, you know, there's gonna be one most important one to you. And I want you to be able to determine that like right now and actually post it right down below the video for me, you know. Because it's important to me to kind of know why you guys are gardening. It'll help me tailor my videos to meet, you know, the majority of your guys' needs. Of course, if you're gardening for some weird reason, I don't know if I'll ever cover that in an episode. But at least it'll give me some ideas, you know, because I know a lot of people out there, they're gardening to save money. And, you know, sometimes the stuff I use is not in line with saving money. I mean, there's ways to do it cheaper and whatnot, but, you know. But anyways, the reason why I garden, and this is my top criteria, with other reasons play an influence too in my gardening style, is because I'm growing food for the highest quality nutrition. You know, I want to be as healthy as I could be. I almost lost my life when I was in my 20s because of spinal meningitis, which was caused by complement immune deficiency, which, you know, down the road I learned that, you know, literally you are what you eat, and we've heard this before, and your genes are a reflection of, you know, your diet and whatnot, epigenetics. And I learned that I really need to start eating healthier. So I was on my healthy eating program and always try to improve what I'm doing. The only way I could improve my diet and what I was doing, I learned, was to grow my own food so I could have ultra premium quality food, because unfortunately the industrial agriculture system, whether it's conventional or organic foods, is not doing that. Even many local farmers are not growing food in the way that I would like. So I'm taking responsibility and doing it for myself so that I'll have the highest quality food, because if you're eating the highest quality food, you know, you're gonna be the highest quality. So higher quality food equals higher quality people. I think it's really sad in America today that literally people are eating junk food, and guess what's happening? They're turning into junk. I mean, there's a really good movie by Disney, actually. It's called WALL-E, on how people end up in on these little motorized wheelchairs because they're too fat, and, you know, and then they're just following everybody instead of like, dare to be different. And yeah, that's another reason why I'm gardening, because I dare to be different. I like doing things differently and shaking people up with having a front yard that has all edible vegetables instead of just a lawn, because, you know, there's a lot of people out here, a lot of people out there like me that like to be different. Some people like to fit in, yeah, then have a backyard garden instead of a front yard garden. But, you know, I started growing food to have the highest quality nutrition, but guess what? I've also learned that along with the highest quality nutrition, the food's gonna taste better. And, you know, so I'm meeting a few needs with just that goal. So that being said, because gardening on the cheap is not my number one A1 goal, I'm gonna do what I need to do to have the highest quality food. And based on my research, I've learned that some of the things that I add in my garden are critical for high quality food. I mean, I don't care how you guys garden, really. You could have some soil and get some Miracle-Gro. I mean, I really don't care. I would tell you that I do not recommend that gardening style, but Miracle-Gro is relatively cheap. You could just garden in your soil and you could get some okay to marginal results sometimes, because that stuff does work. But what I'm telling you is that you could do it better, and I don't want you just to settle for less, because think about it. I said it earlier, you are what you eat. If you're eating junk food, you're eating food, you know, grown in your garden on, you know, Miracle-Gro, or maybe by not adding anything to put back into the soil what you're taking out, you're not gonna have the highest quality food, you're not gonna have the highest quality health. And one of the things that I've learned above all else in this life is that you wanna value your health more than anything. Even all the money in the bank is not worth your health. Think about it. There's millionaires, trillionaires, gazillionaires that are in the hospital because of heart disease or whatever, and, you know, they could write the doctor a check for a billion zillion dollars, to guarantee they wouldn't, you know, that they would get out of there. But the doctors can't guarantee that they're going to get out of there, even if they've got the most money. You know, we got to take responsibility. So yeah, sometimes I got to buy some stuff and pony up with some ingredients to put in my garden so I can have the highest quality food, so I can be the highest quality person. Because let me tell you, almost losing your life is not fun, and I don't want any of you guys to do it. So that's why I recommend, you know, eating a diet rich in fresh fruits and vegetables, especially the ones you're growing, and the things like the rock dust, the worm castings, the mycorrhiza, the, you know, standard thermal compost and the fungal-based compost, and basically modeling nature, and that's how I work. So that's why I have to buy something sometimes, some inputs to bring into my garden. I mean, some of you guys might have the goal, I'm gonna be 100% sustainable and I'm not bringing any inputs and buying anything to put in my garden. That's great. There's ways you could do my gardening style for less. And now what I'm gonna do is actually share some of those tips with you. Number one, I would not have to buy an iota of compost ever if I made it myself. Super simple. Everybody out there, as long as you got some land, some space, you can make compost. You do not need to buy a compost tumbler. You know, you need to just have some space where you could pile up the ingredients. And many of the ingredients you may be able to get for free, actually. So besides just the, you know, the yard waste and food scraps that you're generating, you could go out and ask your neighbors for leaves. You could go call tree companies and get wood chips. You could go out to restaurants or supermarkets and ask them for their old produce scraps or produce that's gone bad and take it in compost to make your own compost for free. So compost can be made for free, and that is the thermal-based compost with heat using bacteria. Another very valuable compost that I've learned about is the wood chip-based compost, which is the fungal-dominated compost. So for this, all you need to do is call a tree company and get all their wood chips and pile them up in your yard. And, you know, as long as it's not against regulations where you live, pile up big stacks in your yard and just keep them piled up there and inoculate them with some mushrooms. Or, I mean, the mushrooms will probably come on their own, but I like to speed things up whenever possible and pile them up. And in about 3 years, you're going to have some dark, rich, black, gold, free, fungal-dominated compost. So there we got two of the ingredients that I often use, you know, in my gardening style that I might have to buy because I'm gardening so much and I don't have that much waste and I don't want to dedicate my resources, such as my space or my time, to do it. I'd rather have somebody else do it and buy it and bring it in, because that's more important to me. If you have a lot of space, you might want to do that, or if you don't have enough money, you might want to just make those things for free, and it just takes some time. That's all right. The next thing I use is the worm castings. So what you could do is you could just dig up your garden and start separating out the red wigglers if you have them in your garden. If not, go to a friend's garden or the nature where you could dig up some red wigglers. And it's going to take you a while to dig up a lot. That's why I prefer to buy them personally. And then start feeding them your food scraps or your finished compost, and they'll make worm castings for you. So instead of buying the worm castings, you guys could make them free and clear. You know, by having a worm bin, whether it's a simple, you know, a tote, or whether it's a box you built out of wood, or whether it's a dish pan, you could keep worms literally in a dish pan. So you could have your own free worm castings. Another kind of casting I've talked about recently is the mealworm castings. If you live down in Compton, California, or LA, actually, you know, what I heard is recently, you could go there and give them and get them for free because they have an overload and they need to get rid of them. That being said, many of you guys may not be that lucky, and they may actually not be giving them away at this point, but maybe charging a few bucks, which I still think is a good deal. But you could actually get your own mealworms. So you'll have to buy some mealworms and let them go through their life cycle. There'll be a mealworm. You'll feed them food scraps and whatnot, and then they'll poop out their castings, and then they'll go through their life cycle and turn into beetles, and then they'll lay more eggs, and then they'll hatch. And you can keep that going to make your own insect frass for your garden. So that's another input you can use. Now, another thing that I use oftentimes is the mycorrhiza. This is basically the mycorrhiza. They colonize the root zone, either inside or outside the root zone, depending on the plant, and they help escort nutrients into the plant and create a whole network in the soil that basically helps with nutrient uptake. I buy the stuff because it's just super easy to do that. I mean, it is in some soil mixes, but I'd rather buy a little jar of it. And all you gotta do is put a little sprinkling on the roots as you're planting your plants out. Now, if you want this stuff for free, what you're going to do is you're going to go to somebody's garden, like a friend's, or maybe out in the forest or something where they're growing a similar plant, because a similar plant's going to attract the mycorrhizae to it. And as long as a place has healthy soil, it's probably got some mycorrhizae in there that you can then take some of the dirt from a tomato plant, for example, that's been added with mycorrhizae. They're living in the root zone. You're going to dig up some of that soil and bring that into your garden and put that next to your tomato in the root zone, and then they'll probably colonize your root zone. And then you'll get your free mycorrhizae. And see, some of the other ingredients I use is the rock dust. You know, a way you can get free rock dust, you know, I get the horticultural grade rock dust, which is the proven right stuff, because there's all kinds of deposits of rocks, and the horticultural grade rock dust are specific rocks chosen specifically for horticultural uses. But free rock dust may be available at a local rock and stone quarry. You know, rock and stone quarries, they take rocks, they grind them up into different sizes for, you know, underlayment of streets and for base layers and for rocks for decoration. And most of them get this waste product called the dust, the rock dust that just comes off after they're done grinding their rocks up. And most people don't want the stuff. And some places, but not all, will give it away for free or for a low cost in big truckloads. You know, bring your pickup truck and they'll fill it up for, I don't know, $5-$10. That's a non-horticulture grade, but nonetheless, I think in most cases, some rock dust is better than no rock dust. You know, one of the other products I use is the C90. And the C90 is a trace mineral supplementation for the garden, derived from the ocean. And it's evaporated minerals from the ocean in a special location that has more concentrated minerals than other places. You know, how could you get this stuff for free? Very simple. Go to your local health food store. Go to the bulk bin section. Go buy some sea salt. Make sure it's sea salt. And you want to get the sea salt that doesn't look white and crystal clear, like all white. You want it nice and gray and, you know, funky colors. The gray stuff has more minerals in it. Now, yes, you will definitely want to dilute that stuff down like 1 teaspoon per 1 gallon of water and then water your plants with it. That's going to be better than not using it. And you do not want to water like with that stuff every single time. You want to like maybe do like a week on and then a week off. Because otherwise you get too much actually sodium buildup. You could use the rock dust minerals in as much quantity as you want. So, you know, those are some of the techniques I use. And I mean, I buy a lot of the different inputs I use simply because it's a lot easier and I'm going to get proven results. You know, some of the ways that I shared with you guys in this video, you know, may not work as well as getting the right stuff for the right job. I mean, my grandfather always told me the right tool for the right job. How many times have you guys tried to like unscrew a Phillips head screw with a straight slot? I mean, yeah, it kind of works, but man, right tool for the right job. That's why I invest in all these different products to put in my garden so that I could meet my number one goal with gardening, which is having the most nutrient dense possible food. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode learning how you can garden literally, you know, with little to no money and still get some of the similar results that I'm getting by using some of the techniques I've shared with you guys today. I mean, mainly what we're doing is we're cultivating and building the soil however we can, putting more organic matter back in the soil, you know, because as we're growing plants, the plants are sucking out the nutrients and we want to put those nutrients back in the soil. So composting, top of the list, whether you're going to do thermal composting, fungal-based composting at low temperature, whether you're going to do the worm castings or the insect frass, or putting things on back, through the minerals, through the sea salts or through the rock dust powders. These are all beneficial methods that I definitely would encourage you guys to do for free or cheap if you can't afford the right stuff. You know, no longer do I want this to be, oh, gardening some exclusive thing. You got to have money to do it. No, you could do it on the free and cheap. Look at Craigslist, you know. Some people give away compost sometimes or horse manure, which is another great resource. You could take horse manure if you don't have any money. I mean, I wouldn't do that. I would rather do composting with vegetable food scraps, but you could get free horse manure, pile it up with free wood chips and let it compost. And using that compost after it's been fully composted is better than not using it at all. That being said, I'd rather use a vegetative compost. I mean, there's many ways to garden on the free and cheap. I would encourage you guys to start using your heads and thinking about some of the ways, hey, how would John do this? Think about it that way. How would John do this if he didn't have any money? I mean, I'm on a limited budget, just like everybody out there, and I try to get the most important stuff that's going to do well for my garden so that I'll get the optimal growing results, because that's what it's all about to me. I want to get optimal growing results, have the healthiest plants so I could, you know, not have to deal with the bugs and the pests and the diseases, and have the highest quality, best tasting food that I'm putting in my mouth. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Once again, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing. All right, this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you, and this one's going to be pretty cool. What I'm going to do is show you guys how to use some of the greens you are growing.